Hey everybody, I'm Stefan for a++.com, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to create the look from the Iron Man series of the promos that I did, the grids, the particles, the glows, and basically how to composite the ready elements that we have from the previous tutorials. And basically this applies for all three different widgets that we did a tutorials about from the series. So I'm going to show you everything, and the glitch effects that we have here and there, and basically create this awesome look. So let's delete this preview video, and what I have in my project is the ready elements that we have from our previous tutorial, as you can see. And now I'm going to start building the environment. So let's start with creating a new solid layer, and let's call it BG for background, and click OK and put it below everything. And let's come to effect, generate, and let's apply ramp, and let's set the start point in the center and change the ramp to radial ramp. And let's change this like so, and let's make this a black color, and let's make this a pretty dark color. I'm going to use the original color I used in the promo. So with that ready, we need to create a new solid layer and call it grid, and set it with a pretty big size, as you can see. And let's click OK and come to effect, generate, and let's apply grid. And let's change the grid size from to width slider, and let's set the border of the grid to 2, and now let's set the width to 128, and let's zoom a bit in order to see the grid. And now we need to duplicate the grid, set the opacity to 50% for the grid, and we need to duplicate the grid, and we need to set this to 32 and the border to 1, and basically that's it for it. And what we need to do is to set this with a normal blending mode in order to see the previous grid as well. And let's turn this into a 3D layer and put it below everything. And now let's hit P for the position, and hold down shift and hit R for the rotation. And we need to set the X rotation to 90 degrees for this one, and we need to set the position to 120. And now we need to duplicate this layer and again hit P and R, and we need to set this to 360, and we need to duplicate it once again, hit P and R, and we need to set this to 0 as well. And now we need to duplicate this one once again, and we need to hit R and set this to 0, and set the Y rotation to 90, and hit P for the position, set this to 0 and this to 360. And basically we need to duplicate this once again and hit P for the position and set this to 1280. And basically that's the grid. If we go to the custom view, you can see how it looks like. We have three layers of grid in the center and two on the two sides. And if we go to the active camera, this is my original camera. It's static, not animated one, but you can see the depth of field is on, and you can see the aperture and the blur level, and the focus distance, which changes from time to time because it's the animation I used in the promo where the element rotates and I need to change the focus from the front element to the back one and so on. And that's it for the grid. Now we need to create a new layer and let's call it particles micro and let's make it comp size and hit OK. Now let's go to effect, trap code and apply trap code particular and let's open the emitter and set the particles per second to 1500 and let's change the emitter type to box and now let's change the velocity to pretty low number like 25% and let's set the size for the box emitter to a pretty large size as you can see like so and we have some beautiful particles which are off focus some of them and we need to open the emission extras and set the pre-run to 100% so we have particles emitted at the beginning of the scene and now we need to open the particle and set the particle life to 6 seconds and let's set the sphere feather to 0 and you can see how this affects our particles and we need to set the size to 0.5 which will make the particles like super small particles as you can see and this adds just a bit of detail and we need to open the opacity overlife and let's use this preset here and basically that's it for the particles. Now we need to duplicate this layer and we need to open it and let's call it particles large and for this layer we keep the exact same settings, we just change the number of particles to a lower number and probably change the random seed and let's set the size to 2 and basically that's it. As you can see this looks pretty good so far. Now we need to create a new solid layer and let's call it glass dirt and let's click OK and come to effect, video copilot and apply optical flares. Now let's open the first one and let's clear all and come to the lens texture here by selecting the global parameters here and we need to choose a texture and for this I think I'm going to use this one and use the default settings and click OK and for the core I'm going to use the original core I used and for the brightness I'm going to set this down to 70% and now I'm going to duplicate this, set the brightness to 35%, open the options and change the texture type to a different one like this one as you can see and click OK and this will add some detail to our scene as you can see and we can change this to add in order to get more details and you can increase the brightness and opacity and stuff like that but later on I'm going to add a glow and this will change the look of the whole scene. Now let's create a new adjustment layer and let's rename this one to glow and let's click OK and come to effect, stylize and let's apply glow and as you can see This is how it affects our scene right now. We need to change the glow threshold to 70% and set the glow radius to 30 and set the glow intensity to 0.8 to tone down the glow a bit. And now we need to create another layer, and let's call this one sharpen and click OK. Come to effect, blur and sharpen, and let's apply sharpen, and let's set this to 10 and let's come to effect, color correction levels, and let's give it just a bit of contrast, and that's it. Let's save the project and let's create a new layer, and let's call it OF for optical flares, and make it black color, and come to effect, video copilot, and apply optical flares. Open the options for the optical flares and let's go to the Pro Presets 2 and let's make this a bit smaller so we can see it. Go to the Pro Presets 2 and let's apply the NASA Dark Sky flare and let's click OK. And with this flare we are going to set the blending mode to add, change the color of the flare to the color I used originally, which is this color, and come to effect, blur and sharpen, and let's apply a fast blur and set it to 150 pixels and click the repeat edge pixels. Come to effect, color correction, and let's apply levels and set the input black to 20 just to tone down the glow of the flare, and set the opacity of the layer to 25%, and let's saw this and take the flare and let's move it here at this point, and now let's create a basically a copy of the layer, and let's change the opacity to 100% and change the blending mode to screen, and let's open the optical flares and go to the custom presets, and we are going to apply this one right here and let's click OK. Basically, as you can see, this is how it looks, and we need to put it around here, and now we need to create a new layer, and let's call it OF again for optical flares, and let's apply again optical flares. We need to open the properties and go to the custom flares and apply this one here, and let's see, we need to come to effect, blur and sharpen, and let's apply fast blur and set this one to 100 and let's set the blur dimensions to vertical, and let's create a duplicate of the blur, set this to 25 and set it to horizontal, and take the flare and put it, let's saw the layer, and let's see, we can put it here and change the blending mode to screen and set the opacity to 50% for this one, and now let's save the project. Finally, we need to create a new black solid and let's call it vignette, and let's take the ellipse tool and double click to create the ellipse mask, set the mask to subtract, set the blending mode to quasi core burn and hit MM to review the mask properties, and set the feather to 400% and hit T for the opacity and set the opacity to 5%, and as you can see this affects our scene, and now we need to create a new adjustment layer and come to effect, stylize and apply glow, and set the glow radius to 100 and keep everything else by default, and come to tint, color correction and apply tint, and set the tint to 15% because it's too saturated right now, and come to noise and grain and apply noise, remove the use color noise checkbox here, and let's set this to 6, and as you can see, this is the final look of our widget. Now we need to create some glitch effects and stuff like that, so let's go to our project and let's take the final comp, which is this one here, and put it into another composition. And originally what I did was to render this as a QuickTime video file and then import it and apply the glitch effects in order to save some render time, but for this tutorial I'm going to show you just how to create a few glitch effects, and then you can render it and do it by yourself. So let's create a new solid and let's call it Fractal Matte, and let's show the layer, come to effect, noise and grain, and apply fractal noise. We need to change the fractal type from basic to something like turbulent smooth, for example. We can try it, and let's change the noise type to block. And as you can see, if we use the basic one, it doesn't look that good, so we need to change it to something else and basically play with the settings and increase the detail, or you can decrease it depending of what you want. And let's increase the contrast quite a lot, and we can open the transform and just scale this like so, and we need to make this like 5 frames long. And now let's create a new adjustment layer and let's make it 5 frames long as well, and we are going to see the original and go to noise and grain and apply noise, and this time use core noise and set this to 20 or 30, come to effect, stylize and apply mosaic, and set this to the original size and divide it by 6 to get this look. And as you can see, this is what we get without the noise. It looks too clear, that's why we add noise. And if we use this as a Luma mat, you can see that we get this kind of a distortion glitch effect only on some places. And now we can apply blur and sharpen this to make it more visible, and probably this is way too high, try to keep it something cool like 40, and we need to apply a color correction levels, and you can increase the brightness for it, for example you can tweak the contrast here and make it like so, and probably increase the contrast here as well, and it all depends of the effect you're going for. And we can select this and duplicate it, select the adjustment layer, and let's remove all of the effects, and we can come to let's see distort, and wave warp. And wave warp is a pretty cool effect. We can turn off the layer below and let's set the direction like so and turn off this so it affects the full image and you can see better what we do. So let's set this to square and let's set this to like a wall number like 10% or 5, and let's set this to 15 and let's try some other presets, smooth, or we can use noise, which is pretty cool I think. And the noise one looks most like a distortion or system glitch and stuff like that. The others are just not so natural. So if we change this to a mat, you can see that it affects only a parts of the image, and if we turn on this, and probably we need to tone down this effect, and we can change the evolution of the noise or the random seed here in the evolution options, and this will change the shape of the mat. And as you can see, we have some different glitch effects here and there, and this is pretty cool. Another thing that you can do is to duplicate this and move it here, is that you can apply some pretty dramatic color correction like Leos and increase the contrast like so, and after that apply some stylized go effects and do something like that, and then you can apply noise and grain to add some more detail and set this to 10% for example, or 50 to make it more visible. And as you can see, this creates another type of glitch effect. And finally, you can apply color correction tint and tint it quite a lot, because the glitch effects are not that colorful, and you can change the type of the fractal noise mat. For example, if you open the transform and you can stretch it like so and bring the brightness and the contrast, change them, and you can create a different type of glitch effect. As you can see, probably the noise is way too much here. We can change this to 15 or 25 like so, and basically you can apply a color correction, hue and saturation, and you can shift the hue. For example, you can create something like a different color grade, you know. You have to take a look at some glitch effects from movies to see how it looks like, but basically there is not a rule, and you can do it by yourself and use your imagination. And another thing that I used a lot was to, let's create another adjustment layer and make it a few frames long, and let's apply effect video copilot twitch. And I used a lot of twitch, and basically I use it for the RGB split and some random glitches, for example. So let's enable the swipe and let's open the behavior and the controls for the swipe, and let's set the swipe motion blur to 0 and the swipe RGB split to 100%, and let's increase the amount and the speed. And as you can see, it's a pretty high number right now, so let's set this to 100% and let's set this to 5, and let's increase this a bit and change this to 15. And we need to set this to, let's see, like 5, and we need to go to the settings here and let's set this to 0. And this white amount, we need to set this to a war number like 15. And basically you can use this to create some random jumps in the picture and create some RGB split effects. And basically if we set this white spread to 0, we can use this slider to tell how it needs to rotate. So it right now it's only up and down, and if we set this to 0 or to 90 degrees, it's left to right. So that's a cool thing to know if you have Twitch. And basically you can recreate this effect by taking the final comp, creating a duplicate of it or the final QuickTime file, and apply effect color correction. And let's choose the channel mixer and let's set the red to 100%. And now we can duplicate this, reset this and set the red to 0 and the blue to 0, so we have only the green channel, and make duplicate, reset it again, and now we need to have the blue channel only. And as you can see, if we take these three of them and set the blending mode to add or screen, we have the final. And if we take one of them and slide it to the left and the other one and slide it to the right, you can see that you get kind of a RGB split again. And this is for those of you who don't have the Twitch plugin. And basically you can keyframe the position or the scale with type of a wiggle expression, or just put a few keyframes and create this kind of RGB split effect. So basically this is how to create the look from the promo from the series for the Iron Man widgets. Hope you like this tutorial and find it useful. Once again, I'm Stefan for a.touchplus.com, and we'll see you next time.